From Amateur Radio Newsline Report number 2166, these are the Ham Nation headlines for Wednesday, May 8th, 2019. Our top story this week is the earthquake that shook the Philippines in late April. Members of the Ham Emergency Radio Operations Net were more than ready.
When a 6.1 magnitude earthquake rattled Luzon Island and its surroundings in the Philippines Monday, April 22, barely 2 minutes elapsed before emergency ham radio operations were on the air. The Ham Emergency Radio Operations, or HERO Network, of the Philippine Amateur Radio Association, PARA. HERO began handling traffic on 7.095 MHz, which someone is always monitoring. The 40-meter frequency was utilized in parallel with 144.740. As soon as health and welfare and other relevant information was received by HERO Net Control, details were posted in the HERO thread on the Facebook group, PARA 2019. The quake was measured at a depth of 21 kilometers, but could be felt in Metro Manila, most of central Luzon, and as far as some parts of the Ilocos regions. CNN reported that nearly 30 structures were damaged by the first quake, and some regions had power outages. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Graham Kemp, VK4BB.
When flames consume the landscape where Brunei and Malaysia meet, Hams provided firefighters with a lifeline.
With tenacious peat fires breaking out near the border of Malaysia and Brunei in late April, fire and rescue personnel had more than just overwhelming flames to deal with. They battled poor radio coverage within the government's integrated radio network they utilise. The Miri Amateur Radio Club, however, was able to rescue the rescuers with use of their communications equipment. According to a report in the Borneo Post, the ham radio links gave the firefighters what they needed to get in touch with their operations centre. The firefighters created a firebreak around an area of around 120 acres. Fire officials told the newspaper that the wind direction was also creating intense smoke that crossed the border into Brunei. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Robert Broomhead, VK3DN.
An influential, long-time contributor to CQ Magazine is now a silent key.
The CQ Magazine editor who envisioned the creation of a DX Hall of Fame has become a silent key. John Attaway, K4IIF, had been the magazine's DX editor and member of the staff for two decades. In 1967, at his urging, the magazine established the DX Hall of Fame to recognize excellence among radio operators. Trained as a research chemist, the Winter Haven, Florida resident built a career in the science of the chemistry of flavors, focusing on his state's citrus industry. His work eventually landed him in a Hall of Fame as well. In 2001, the Florida Citrus Hall of Fame honored him for his work as the Director of Scientific Research for the Florida Department of Citrus. John Attaway, who died on April 15th, was 88. For Amateur Radio Newsline, I'm Dave Parks, WB8ODF.
CQ Publishing is a corporate sponsor of Newsline's Young Ham of the Year Award, along with Yaesu USA, Heil Sound, and Radio Waves Antennas. Our condolences to all who knew him. There are only a few weeks left in the nominating period for the Newsline WA6ITF Young Ham of the Year Award. Full details in the nominating form can be found on our website, arnewsline.org, under the YHOTY tab. Nominations close May 31st at midnight Eastern Time. We'll present the award in August at the Huntsville Ham Fest in Alabama. We hope to see you there. And that's all from the Amateur Radio Newsline, your independent source for amateur radio news for four decades and counting at arnewsline.org. With Graham Kemp, VK4BB, Robert Broomhead, VK3DN, Dave Parks, WB8ODF, Karen Eve Murray, KD2GUT at the news desk in New York, and our news team across the globe, I'm Don Wilbanks, AE5DW. 7-3, we'll see you next time here on Ham Nation.